On the day I play golf, I feel raring to go. I wait for my lift to come, minibus with my helper, and we go. I have my golf shoes on, and I take my glove with me, put my glove on. When we get there, it is amazing. We all get out of the minibus, and there's three of us who go together, sort of thing. And we guide each other. They hold onto my stick, and they've got a stick at the front. And the chap who's not blind, he holds onto us at the front, sorry. And it's like a train moving along. We hold our hand on the shoulder of each person. It is, when you see it, if you haven't known I was blind, it would be like sort of having fun, but it's not having fun, it's getting there. And when you move away from the van to go towards the tee on the range, there are so many lovely people around there, so many lovely helpers, men and women. They give so much to me and others. I come down into where the range is. And we stand there, we do practice. And there are so, there are people say, oh, don't worry, Colin, we've got straight in front. And we get onto the path, onto the grass. And we stand on the tee. And we bring everything to the tee. I mean, hope. We bring skill, we bring talent. So when I stand on that tee, I know where I want to be. And I can hear people in calling, Colin, yep, I put the ball down. See, that's what they have to do. I put the ball down. And it's up to you, Colin, now. And I bring the club back, and I bring it right down by the side of my knee. And when I do that, I make contact with the ball head on. They are so astonished. They can't believe it. Because blind and disabled golfers across the world are doing so much for the game. They're putting so much in. And what we do, it's amazing. And when I hit the ball, it goes miles. And I hear in the distance, that's over 200 yards. And you hear the people. Your hearing is fantastic. It's like someone switched on the stereo. You hear it with a speaker. And you hear them in the background going, oh, wow. You can hear people saying, oh, that was the wrong shot. Not me, but other people. But they get it right in the end. And when we get it right in the end, we have a blind golf team. There was 8 of us, I think. Yeah, 8. Then we go through all the playing golf, playing different shots, playing different clubs. It is so marvellous because we are doing things, blind people, blind golfers and sportsmen and sportswomen, have, just for taken for granted. We are finding things out. Because when we go, we touch the pavement with our sticks. Where the grass is in the pavement. We touch all the things in the middle of the path and everything, and we know where we go. It's our winding path towards the range. And we give so much. But for people that are not blind, they go there and they just think, oh, wow. I have a few shots and that's it. But with us, we have to have a minibus. We have 8 of us. We have so many, we have helpers. And it's amazing. It's amazing what love can do. The miracle. Every single person on that coach is devoted to golf. Devoted to another sport, which is cricket. They play that, I don't. They have They have devotion to the game. They're dedicated to the game. They're part of the game. So when you get on the tee and play a shot, think of the blind people, disabled people around the world who play golf. They have no chance to moan, which they don't. They don't throw their clubs in the air and go mad. They don't chuck their club in the wood or stick it in the rough or break it because they're so fed up with their shot. Nothing works like that. But you don't get anywhere condemning people. You get everywhere by involving people, by sharing your knowledge, by sharing what you know, and to advise them on what you know. It's amazing. Every single time I hear on the news, sometimes in the golfing news, oh, someone's blown his top, someone's sacked somebody, or someone's got this, someone's got that. You don't get anywhere like that. But that's nothing against Rory McIlroy. Rory McIlroy is a fantastic player. He just left his coach, and his trainer, and that was it. His caddy, sorry, and that was it. But he will improve. He will get there in the end. I love golf. I love everything about golf. Rory McIlroy, you're an amazing golfer. You will click again soon. You have had a bad injury, but keep going and you'll get there in the end. Everything I know, I advise, give advice people, advice to people. I give advice to everyone about golf. My inspiration is amazing across the world. People are saying, I'm a golden inspiration. I'm so proud about that. But I just want to say this. This is Golden Inspiration 5. Every single part of golf is perfection. I mean, when I get there, I take shots and play the shots. We go down and play our iron shots. That's how it should be done. Not because you made a mistake. You blow a fuse. You blow a fuse, you lose. When you stand in the rough, I've heard on the radio, on the television the other day, people standing in the rough and they hit the ball and it doesn't go out very far. Oh, they go mad. They go mad. They say, oh no, bloody ball, you know, like that. And they moan about the club. But it's not about the club. It's the golfer. It's the player. Your club cannot answer back, but you can, because you were in the wrong. You blame everything, and you blame everything on your club. You never blame yourself. A blind and disabled golfer does not blame anything on himself. He goes there and he plays the shot. So don't blame your club, blame yourself. You don't get anywhere by blaming anybody else. All you get is bad feeling. So take your club and hit the ball, and don't let's have any more of this throwing clubs in the air business. It doesn't help in any way. Coaches will tell you it takes time to play golf. Golf stars, you are amazing, every single one. But I hear all these things about people throwing them in the river, clubs and things. Doesn't get anywhere. Your judgment is not very good then, because your attitude stinks. Your attitude means you don't get around anywhere. And I'd just like to say this: every single one of the golfing people I know does not throw a ball, so not throw the club in the river. They bring life back into golf. That's blind and disabled people playing golf. They don't hurt anybody by hitting into the woods. They just carry on with life. When people say, oh, just missed the bus, damn it. Is that all they got to worry about? Missing the bus, that's nothing. Think of a blind disabled golfer who has, or a blind disabled person who has to get on with life. That's why we don't moan. That's why we get on with life. And that's why we play golf to win. So all this is amazing, yes. But I want to say this. We should never think of throwing things in the rivers and things. Just concentrate on your game and you'll get your aim. Okay. Good night, everybody, and I'll see you in the morning. Thanks. Bye.